So my name is Emil Lundberg. I work at Yubico, and one of the things I do there is I help develop this standard, WebAuthn, which is an open standard for sign-in on the web, which makes you practically immune to phishing attacks.
We have been bugged by two problems. Well, phishing is one of them. The other one is password use, because passwords is the cause of a lot of trouble, right?
Yeah. And one of the ways you can use WebAuthn is you can use it completely without passwords, and you can still do two-factor authentication. And in the best case, you might not even need a username to use WebAuthn. First and foremost, you need some kind of device that's compatible with this. But the good news is that support for this is now built into most of the major operating systems. So if you have an Android or iOS or Mac device or a Windows device, then you probably have support for this built in. There's also support for external keys, like the YubiKey, for example, which is a little hardware device that also speaks the same protocols. And so if you're especially interested in security, or if you, for example, are using Linux, or you want to use your keys on multiple devices, then you can get a YubiKey and have your keys on that instead. The original started in about 2014, where Yubico and Google together developed a protocol called U2F, which is short for Universal Second Factor, which pioneered most of these features. And now WebAuthn is the successor of that standard, which adds a few new more features like this multi-factor thing and also passwordless authentication. So WebAuthn is the continuation of that.
And it's developed by a consortium of companies in a working group under the W3C, is that correct?
Correct, yeah. So there's the World Wide Web Consortium, which develops standards for the web. Yeah. And WebAuthn is one of those standards. So in this working group, we have representatives from a lot of different companies, including Yubico, and also Google, Microsoft, Mozilla, and Apple, and also IBM and a few others. It varies over time, but there are a lot of actors there.
Nice.
It's a joint effort by many different companies. So I can answer this in two ways. I'll first answer it in the end user. How does it work for the end user?
Yeah.
And then how does it work technically?
Yeah.
So for the end user, you'll go to a site where you want to log in, and you press the sign in button, and you get a pop-up in your browser that says, do you want to sign in here? And you press yes. And if you have support for this built into your device, then that's all, you're signed in. If you're using a YubiKey, you'll plug in the YubiKey and touch the little disk here, and that's all, you're signed in. And sometimes you might be asked to type in a PIN or scan a fingerprint or something. But that is essentially the user experience. You just press a button and it's done.
That sounds really simple. But I'm guessing it's a bit more complicated on the other end for a website that wants to authenticate users using this protocol.
Yeah, so under the hood, in technical terms, this uses asymmetric cryptography. So before you can do this sign up or sign in ceremony, you need to do a registration ceremony where you create a public and private key pair. And then once you have that, you call a JavaScript API in the browser, which makes a request to the security key. The request to the security key will include a challenge to be signed and also the domain that you're signing in on. And in that way, when you sign this challenge with your security key, that signature is bound to the domain you're trying to sign into. So if you're trying to sign into a different domain, then first the security is going to say, I don't know this domain. Even if you were able to fool the security key, the server is going to see that, hey, this signature doesn't match my domain. So you were probably on a phishing site somewhere. So even if you as a human don't notice that something's wrong, you have this kind of built-in automatic fraud detection. So one of the major challenges with WebAuthn has been that if you register a YubiKey, for example, and then you lose the YubiKey, then you also lose your keys. So you need to register two of them, which is a bit cumbersome. On the other hand, if you register, say, an Android phone, and then you drop your phone in the toilet, then you also lose your keys. Or if you replace your phone, which many people do, like every couple of years, then it's a hassle to get your keys onto the new phone. And one of the new major developments recently was that in a couple of months ago, in about October 2022, Apple and Google and Microsoft together went together and said, we're going to do this new thing that we're calling passkeys. And one of the things included in that is that if you create a WebAuthn key on your like on your computing device, like your phone or your laptop, then that's going to be synced into your cloud account. So like your Google or iCloud or Microsoft cloud account, and synced onto all your devices with that same account. If you are interested in higher security, you can still use a YubiKey and those won't be copied between devices. But for most people, I think will prefer the easier use case of just having the keys everywhere. And that is better than not using WebAuthn, which is what we're really up against.
I mean, getting rid of passwords would be the ideal situation, because we know the passwords are so difficult to use in a secure way.